I did a cross-country drive, just the two of us, something we wanted to do for a long time. I grew up loving cars because of my dad, so it was like a cool bonding moment for us.
I love that. Family memories are always the best, aren't they? It makes us who we are. I want to shift gears for a second and ask, how did you even get into technology?
Well, at first I appreciated the shifting gears.
Right, pun. You know, I wanted you to see it, and you saw it.
I did. I got you. You know, I've always been into tech and products. I'm a nerd. Like, I've always been a nerd.
Me too.
I got my first pair of glasses because I built a screensaver for my optometrist.
You willed a deal with your optometrist?
Yeah,
it's no wonder you're the vice president of the metaverse. This is a major stuff going down. So before we get really into it, Michelle, I gotta ask big picture, you know, because I'm sure everybody wants to know, and I personally want to know as well. How do you describe, you know, in simple terms, the metaverse to someone that has no clue what it's about?
I think the simplest way of thinking about it is the metaverse is the next phase of the internet. Mm-hmm. And the main difference between the internet we use today and the next phase is that we can feel like we are there with other people in a way that we can't feel in our digital experiences today. And we're gonna see things around us. We're gonna be able to touch things with our hands.
Well, don't start touching stuff in here, Michelle, because
I don't know what all these buttons are gonna be.
We don't know where we're gonna end up.
Yeah.
We're going deep into the metaverse. What is that? A flamingo in the middle of the street? How am I gonna get past that?
We're just gonna go right under it, obviously.
So let me get this right. You're the vice president of the metaverse at Meta, but you're not the vice president of the entire metaverse, right? I mean, am I sitting with royalty?
No. There's no one person or one company that will control and or create the metaverse. It's like saying there's one person who runs the internet.
I thought it was me who ran the whole internet.
So that's the actual answer? At Meta, we've been working on a product called Horizon Worlds.
Horizon World, okay.
I should get you to intro this
product. I know, I'm ready, Horizon World. It sounds very on the horizon.
That is why it's called Horizon Worlds, that's right. But the idea is that as opposed to Meta, a company building all the experiences that people will have, Horizon Worlds lets you or anyone create an experience.
So I really love this. So what you're saying is within the metaverse, I can create my own places. Like, it's not only one company or the people that have the big bucks. It can actually be anyone that has an idea.
That's right. And I think this is really an extension of how technology has sort of democratized access to tools and to creativity. Like, think about 10 years ago, did we all think we'd have a video studio in our pockets?
Okay,
right?
No.
We didn't, right? Like, the phone kind of evolved to be that. And similarly, before it took writing, you know, thousands of lines of code to build a virtual environment. And now we're building products where, using your hands in VR, you can build an environment.
So are people building things in the metaverse that even you didn't expect?
Yeah, all kinds of interesting things. We've got people building comedy clubs, speakeasies, haunted houses, meditation spaces. All these things, the thing that's common is they're experiential.
When you talk about speakeasies or going to bars and clubs, I mean, are there people that are gonna help me to keep my own space?
Well, look, the most important thing, I think, is for people to feel safe and feel comfortable. Also, when you are in a public space, what kind of superpowers can we give you to control your own experience?
I like the sound of that.
Imagine you're out in the world, physical world, and someone's harassing you or irritating you. Wouldn't it be nice if you could make a gesture and block them?
Oh my gosh, I would love to do that. I would just love to be like, something like that.
That's the gesture we're gonna use,
and I need the tongue click.
Okay, I got it.
Thanks.
But I think it's a really important thing to give people the feeling that this is for them.
Okay, Michelle, we talked about a lot of big ideas, but to help me understand things a little bit better, I thought we could play a game. Are you up for that?
All right, let's play a game.
All right. This is now, future, never. Well, I'm going to suggest some things that I can do in the metaverse, and then you're going to answer with now, future, or never. Ready?
Seems simple enough. Let's do it.
Can I take my grandma bungee jumping?
Now.
Can I make a clown avatar that isn't scary?
Now.
Make a salad with no food in it?
That's a really deep question, actually, Kiki. Let's say future.
Okay. Visit future Mars with human colonies on it?
Some version of now and future, yep.
Build a human-sized web and hang around it like a human-sized spider.
I think you can do a version of that now.
Yeah. Okay. Can I divide by zero in the metaverse?
Listen, we can break physics, but we can't break math.
Create a giant virtual banana to go rock climbing on.
Now.
What if the banana is rotting?
That's, I guess, the future, since it needs to rot.
Answered that very cleverly. What if the banana is screaming, don't climb me? I just threw that one in for kicks.
that's now. Why not?
Okay, reconstruct the Titanic, sail it past an iceberg, and scream, not this time, sucker!
You can do a version of that now.
And save my good old Jack?
Now.
Good. Can you become a doctor without having to do gross stuff?
let's say that's definitely a never.
Attend a virtual wedding?
No.
Go backstage and meet your favorite fan?
No.
Go backstage and meet your favorite band's parents?
I guess now, if that's important to you.
Can I host this show from my bed at home?
In the future, yeah. I prefer this.
I don't. Okay, well, thanks for humoring me, Michelle. That was very informative. Now, let's press another button and see where else we can go. After learning everything that I've learned, I'm not exactly sure if fine art and design are my thing. So, am I out?
So, no, I don't think so at all. I think this is what's awesome about the tools we're building is that it doesn't have to be fine art or design. It's whatever you want to make. And the tools to build things are available now.
Okay, but Michelle, you're like a black belt in the metaverse. So, I mean, come on, it can't be that easy.
Good ideas aren't easy.
No.
Good ideas are hard. And that's what creativity is. So I can't tell you how to be creative. I don't know if you need my help. That said, the tools are pretty easy.
Oh, wow. Okay, with these tools, who knows what Keegan's going to be doing next. Okay, but I got another one for you.
Okay.
I'm a busy woman, and I'm over here doing big boss things. Sometimes I don't have all the time to put into building in the metaverse. Yeah. So what do I do?
Some people are experts already. And they've spent a lot of time on these tools. And what we've built is ways for them to share their creations so other people can use it.
Okay.
But let's take that even a step further. How do you make it so that maybe just by communicating with an AI, artificial intelligence builder bot, you can tell it what you want it to build and it'll build it for you?
Now, wait a minute. You telling me I can vocally delegate to somebody?
Something tells me you know how to do that.
Oh, yes. That's exactly up my alley. It sounds like I'm going to fit right in the metaverse.
And again, you need to have an idea. It's not like you say, build me something interesting, and something interesting gets built. You still have to have some concept. But then the tools to make it come to life will just become easier and easier to use. How do you access Horizon Worlds from a phone or from a computer? How do you build using tools you already have? And that's some of the things that we're working on now, too.
Oh, you had me a delegate. This is so exciting. I thank you so much for being on the show, Michelle. This has been really informative.
Thank you so much for having me. It's been a blast.
Join us next time, you guys, and see what else we go into the metaverse and who else is going to be joining us on our journey. By the way, Michelle, have you been looking at the navigation system? Because I have no idea where we're going.
We won't be able to even imagine what the world's gonna. I mean, it might look like this,
exactly.
But also it might look way wilder than this.
Welcome to Our Rebellion, the show where we take a road trip into the metaverse while chatting with the most interesting creators, educators, and experts to find out where the metaverse stands now and what's coming in the future. I'm Kiki Palmer. And today I'm talking with Don Allen, a creator and educator in both VR and AR. Was it wrong?
Oh, hey, how are you doing?
I'm good. Are you ready to get the show on the road?
Oh, yeah.
Let's do it.
Ooh. Mm-hmm. Okay, so
yep.
This is my kind of space.
Okay, I don't know if you meant that pun, but that's fine. I like it. I dig it.
A little forced.
Now, Don, I know you wear many hats. Can you tell me what some of those hats entail? And wear an AR hat while you're there?
Oh, sure thing. Let me just think about it real quick. And there we go. I think we got, this is a little cat hat.
How did you just do that?
I use a lot of different 3D programs and tools. And this one, I modeled it, painted it, give it bones, give it the ability to move. We had to animate it.
So how did you learn how to do all this stuff? I mean, where did that knowledge come from?
Yeah, so I'm fully self-taught. I've been working at DreamWorks for like 3 or 4 years as an educator, and I've made a lot of AR filters for everyone from Lil Nas X to Tiesto.
Okay, Lightflex, but I see. I love that you're self-taught, but sometimes that can be like a hard thing to keep pushing yourself to do. So what drives you?
Yeah, I mean, it's a little serious, but I had like a brain surgery at 18 and then like recovered from it. And then the whole thing made me realize that like I didn't have much control over physical reality, which is what inspires me so much about AR and VR, is like giving that sense of control and agency back and how I want to represent myself, my identity. So like, I'm like half black, half Italian. My whole life, you know, I didn't really fit into the normal tribes that were available to me. People in the past might have been easily typecasted into a binary system of this or that, and that will pretty much be erased.
It yes, would, I love that.
Just be a gradient of identity.
Do you have any AR to illustrate your point?
Yeah, like sometimes like in a metaverse meeting, I need to have like professional Don. So professional Don comes in here and he's got like a button up. He's a little bit more serious, you know? And he got my face, like I'm like, ah, you know?
That is so cool.
But then like other times I want to like be more expressive. I want more color, I want more light, and you know, I want to go big. So then I go like Ice Queen style. My friend Paige did the makeup on the cheeks and the eyes.
Shout out Paige.
Shout out to Paige. And so like when I see this stuff, I'm like, whoa, this is what makeup does?
Yeah, it's pretty cool, dude.
That's pretty cool.
I don't look anything like this.
Exactly. It's gonna be kind of like Halloween almost all the time.
I love that. You're a pretty deep guy.
Oh, thanks. Yeah. We can go way deeper. Might have to reel me back in.
You know, I know a little bit about VR, you know, virtual reality, but I'm still kind of trying to understand AR. Can you explain that to me?
So VR is like all virtual worlds, like we're fully immersed like this. AR could be like a cat on my actual head. And another example of like, you know, AR would be like at a baseball game. You know how like when a pitcher's about to throw the ball, they'll overlay like a box around, yeah. Right? The box isn't really there, but it's like really useful information to overlay on top of reality. That is actually an augmentation of what was the reality. Like right now, you might be seeing that the cat is in front of the windshield here, and that's because AR is usually an overlay on top of the real world. So that's tracking to my face. If I cover my face, we will lose the tracking of the cat.
Don, all your filters are so much fun. Like, I'm pretty inspired by them, and so what? I gotta know, who inspires you? Like, what other illustrators or creators out there?
Ooh, Dunaway Smith. Stuff's amazing. She has these geometric augmented reality things. And then another friend of mine, Steffi Fung. She's got these fantastic virtual outfits, cool cloth simulations. They inspire me all the time.
Speaking of fashion, I think I could really use your eye. Would you be willing to play a game with me?
Around fashion?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. So, I asked the graphic team to kind of, you know, mock up some filters for my ideas. I have no idea exactly what I'm trying to go for, but I figured that you could take a look and let me know if I'm going in the right direction. Yeah?
Yes, be happy to help.
So my fans know me as Big Boss, and of course I need a look for that. So tell me what you think of this mock-up.
Ooh, I love the colors and I love the shine. You got the angular shapes that kind of bring a lot of focus to the center. Yeah. You got the crown that says boss.
Right.
One thing I'm thinking you could do is you can animate the shoulder spikes so that they come out.
Oh my gosh, I love the animated aspect. Cause I love the shoulders pop, you know what I mean? That's like a little throwback to the 80s when the shoulders were super strong 24/7.
Yes.
So I think I love the idea of like, it can go down, but then it can come back up again. So I was thinking about my metaverse movie premiere look. So check this out, let me know what I need to do to raise the stakes. Ooh.
So like for something like this, I'd probably use Spark AR and like just create a bunch of cameras. That would literally, it look like a camera just floating around and they're all trying to get the best angle of you. And like every time you turn, they have to like adjust themselves, you know, and you just like, you know.
Don, I knew you were the perfect person to ask because not only is it fabulous and giving a moment, but it's also giving some humor. And I always love to give that. You know, I don't take myself too seriously. So the idea that I can give you all that class and sass, but then a little bit of a comedy show, the kids will gag. I love it. I love it. Well, that's all I've got. Thanks for playing the Metaverse Fit Check with me. Ready to get back on the road?
Mm-hmm. Let's go.
All right. Okay. So how else do you imagine the Metaverse playing into your effort as, like, an educator?
Like, in the long run, I want to build a planet-sized education system.
Ooh, so you want to be a teacher in the Metaverse?
Well, I would like to be like the catalyst that made education free and accessible for everybody in the world. I always think like what kind of ancestor I want to be. That's the kind of ancestor I want to be.
Come on, ancestor. Yes, I love the ancestors. I call on them every weekend. Oh, I love that sneaker mountain.
I don't think it's my size, though. Speaking of ideas, the future jobs that are going to be popping up in the Metaverse are all going to be around how big of an idea can you imagine?
Oh my gosh, yeah.
I'm seeing how fast AI is improving. And it, you know, people can give a single text prompt and generate worlds now. I honestly think the people that are going to build the best, like, most exciting and engaging worlds in the metaverse are going to be the ones that, like, the poets.
Yeah.
The ones who can, like, verbalize a world. They have the language and their brush strokes are literally just like literary devices.
Oh, I love it so much. It really gets me so excited. And I think that's the point of, like, you know, when we talk about tools, or even when we talk about are we there yet, it's really about us all coming in, adding what we want to make it what it is. You know, it's not going to get there without each and every one of us being able to say, hey, I have an idea.
And that's what I mean. Like, we won't be able to even imagine what the world's going to, I mean, it might look like this. But, like, but also it might look way wilder than this. So, like, if you can call chase fast now, this is, like, the slowest it's ever going to be.
Well, Don, I need to say goodbye, because, man, this has been a blast riding around town with you, man.
It's been amazing.
I think now you've given me, like, the inspiration to try my hand at some AI.
Yes.
Yeah.
Please.
Well, don't be mad when I start blowing up your phone, or worse, taking it live. Oh. Join us next time, you guys, in the metaverse, and see where else we go, and who else is going to be joining me on our journey. Can I, borrow the cup, baby?
Oh, definitely. See ya.
I'm
You wanna? How about you with I? Come on, dear.
Rambling statement. want a Bugatti? Live in a mansion? You wanna pretty?
You wanna?
If you wanna. Better work.
important.
With their eyes shut. This is the best thing since the
You wanna, 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 you wan down.
Thank you.
You better walk, bitch. Knock it to work, bitch.